professional attire, right, of administration, but I had some surgery, so it's not looking pretty up there. So it's better like this. Don't freak anybody out. My name is Joe Cardi, and I'm the Mission Advancement Officer here at Saint Benedict Preparatory School. I have a wonderful job of supporting the CEO. We have a different model, I think they've explained, correct? Okay, so we have a little different model here, and it works very well in our situation. The change, because Ms. Gemma, our CEO, was our principal of the grammar school I was her assistant, they tried to figure out what could do the best possible way to use our resources the best way, which is an easy thing, but more so, warning, but what is best in order to look at the situation academically and provide for the needs of our students, families, and staff, as well as to maintain the basis of what we are, very unique here as a parish entity. Because in many, I don't know how familiar you are with Chicago, but there were many parish high schools at one time. St. Clement's had one, St. Michael's had one. There were many, you know, were in existence because it was just a branch, you know, a fulfilling, well-rounded education for families that, you know, probably couldn't travel much. Now we find ourselves in a very unique situation. And I have the great partnership with the rest of the administrative team to make sure it all happens. You know, we all work together, and I think that's the great thing about this model, is that there is no, you know, big pride thing that, you know, I have to be the top person, I have to be the head person. And it's collaborative. Obviously, the bottom line at one point rests with the pastor at the end. You know, in the end, canon law, you know, the church has canon law, and canon law says the pastor is the end. But luckily, we have a wonderful pastor who is really engaged in Catholic education and really wants the best for the whole block. And we're very fortunate. We're very fortunate. That's not always the case, mainly because in parishes, the school may be seen as a drain. That part of the mission is like an arm that needs to get amputated in a lot of pastors' minds. So as you see Catholic education in an archdiocese like our own, which is constantly changing, you see that struggle. And I don't know if you're in administration or looking to administration and things, that is sometimes why a lot of people hesitate in doing Catholic administration, because that's such a volatile issue. You're working really well with the pastor, your things are moving forward, the program's moving forward, all of a sudden, he's just reassigned, his term is up, a new guy comes in, maybe no experience with Catholic education, may come from a foreign country, as many of our incarnated priests are, where Catholic education basically doesn't exist as it does in America. And they have a little bit of trouble with that. So that's not an easy thing. Here, this model works well. My apologies. As you can see, the pastor is looking to hire a director of operations so that I don't have to do that particular thing right now. And that's why they're calling. There's a lot of construction going on, as you can imagine. And so we're taking care of that. In my role as Mission Advancement Officer, they came up with this position to be different from the president-principal model for the sake where I would take care of coordinating. I don't do all the minutiae or the very detailed specifics. I have a great team that works, I should say, with me instead of for me, okay? And basically, we take care of admissions, what's called in today's terms advancement, which used to be called development, which used to be called fundraising, right? And alumni relations for both elementary and high school. And then basically the special events, communications, the PR, the website, anything that deals with the marketing and, you know, basically promoting the mission. You know, the mission of the school is a very unique one, and that's the job. I'm here to support the CEO in whatever way I can, because that's crucial here. Because at one point, that wasn't. There was no collaboration between the schools. There was a different mindset. We do this thing in our way. Even the teachers felt awkward coming in, you know, to the elementary entrance. So let's say it was raining, pouring cats and dogs outside. They would walk the rest of the block instead of entering through the door of the elementary school, because their door was at the end of the block. And, oh, no, no, you can't, you know. It's like, you know, it was a thing. Now that there's unity, that's the job, to promote unity. And so we're here to facilitate that with a very comprehensive admissions program. The admissions program has developed and come forward a great deal. So there is an interview process, there is letters of recommendation, there is a unique process. Before it was,
they got a pulse.
Okay? You know, they got a pulse, bring them in. You know, no. We want to make sure that A, we are the school that is right for that student and family, and we want to be able to meet the needs. So, for example, let's say that you have dyslexia. Okay? You know, it's not the greatest problem, but, you know, it's a little bit. Can we take care of the need? Let's say that they have a learning disability that requires time in the classroom. We promote, and I'm not sure how much they went into it, we promote inclusive education here, and it is very much not a milestone, but a cornerstone of our program. It's very much who we are, because you're in the right room for this, you know? As long as we are Catholics, we must follow Christ, and Christ was inclusive. And before, you know, I don't know how much you know, if they didn't fit the mold, bye. You know, we're not here to take care of them. You know, that was the mentality. You know, I was principal in schools, elementary schools, where the teachers did not want to take care of a student that needed a little extra help. He said, if he could not learn the way like all the other 30 in the room, see ya, they shouldn't be here. So in that case, there was an issue. There was an issue. And, you know, that's not much you can do. Luckily here, staff, as they're brought on, you know, that's why the CEO has the final say in hiring, you know, because the heads of school do the initial interviewing things, pastor and CEO reassure that it's, you know, in the second interview, third interview, that it is, you know, they're on the ball for all of you see, which is, this is part of our mission. So that's how we assure it. And we want to make sure that that's the case. So in my role, in terms of the admissions, we are assuring that. So we take the time to meet with the family, review an IEP, review, right, individual education plan, because the public schools prepare that, and say, can we take care of that? Because it is wrong. It is really wrong, immoral, or however you want to say, for me to take your money in the tuition and then let you sit in the corner and not teach you.